Welcome to your ultimate Town Hall 9 upgrade guide. In this video, I am going to be sharing with you exactly what you should be upgrading initially at Town Hall 9, where your priorities should lie, and then gradually how you should upgrade your base. Now, a lot of questions I get asked as well for this level is, what attack strategies can I use? What attacks should I be using with low level heroes? So after we have discussed all of the upgrade priorities, showed you how I farm, I will be showing you some war attacks so that you know exactly how to attack with low level heroes. But without further ado, let's get into it. Alrighty guys, let's dive straight into this. I have gone ahead and built all of the new buildings for Town Hall 9. Now I am going to say that I would recommend doing this, however there is one disclaimer that I will discuss first, and it depends where you are in war in terms of your clan. Are you near the bottom? Are you kind of in the middle? Or are you at the top? Are you the number one player of your clan? If you are, then if you go ahead and build the expos, you might be changing things a lot. You will be coming up against a Town Hall 9, so you will have to be able to deal with that. Whereas initially, you might want to wait until you get the queen to level 5, until you get a couple of the new troop upgrades. That was the old style of playing the game in terms of a 0.5 upgrade, and if you are number one in your clan, it might be something to consider. Overcheck the offense rather than the defense. However, the war algorithm is so advanced now that you really don't have to worry about it. So my advice to kick this video off is to go ahead and build all of the buildings, including the expos, drop your archer queen, because you can then go ahead and get some base designs. Once you have all of the buildings built, you can go ahead and copy some bases. You can get them from your clanmates. A very good website that I like to use is from my good friends over at the Clash Champs. Now I will drop that website down in the description of this video. If you're interested, you can head on over there, you can select your town hall level, select what you want to use, whether it be a farming base, a war base, and simply copy it over via the link to your profile, and that's what I would recommend. Get yourself a couple of builds straight away. But you are asking me, what should I upgrade first? What should I prioritize? Well, here goes, guys. If you're new to the channel, by the way, be sure to subscribe and turn on the notification bell. I bring a variety of content here, including Town Hall 9 quite regular, so be sure to subscribe. Now, in terms of the upgrades, if you really want to progress through Town Hall 9 as fast as possible, you're going to want to take advantage of everything in the game, namely the season pass. If you do want to put a little bit of money into the game, it is definitely worth it, guys. Obviously, you will have access to the King and Queen skins. If you do get skins for the Grand Warden, or if they do bring them out for the Royal Champion, you will have them skins when you unlock that hero, but it's obviously later on in the game. If you are going to go ahead and purchase anything, you can go into settings, more settings, and right at the bottom, my content creator boost code is Judo. When you purchase anything in the game using that code, it supports me. I get a little kickback and it is much appreciated. So you can go ahead and do that. Definitely take advantage of the season challenges. Make sure you're in an active clan in order to take advantage of the clan games as well. But when you get the loot, what should you be upgrading? Well, I'm telling you that top of my list was the clan castle. Now, the reason for this is you can use it on offense and defense. So in terms of defense, as long as you've got them clan castle troops in there, it is a stronger defense for you. But not only that, it goes from 25 to 30 housing space. Now, that is important because you can take maxed level troops, especially if you have a town hall 12 or 13 in your clan. You are laughing. But it also allows you to take, let's say, a golem or a lava hound, which you absolutely could not take if it was the level 4. So I would get the clan castle as top of your list. as I've actually just finished the upgrades yesterday, the army camps. They literally cost a couple of million elixir, but it gives you an extra 5 troop capacity per camp. So once you have all 4 of them upgraded, you can have the capacity for 220 instead of 200 troops. It might not seem a lot, guys, but trust me, that is massive. Now, in terms of gold and elixir, you want to be able to manage your builders. You want to try and have your builders upgrading at all times. So all of the stuff I've mentioned at the moment in terms of the army camps will use a lot of your builders. However, only one building there in terms of the clan castle uses the gold, and you probably want to have a good mix of the two. Otherwise, you're going to be stacked with millions of gold and potentially capped out and non-stop using the elixir. However, they would be my first buildings to upgrade. I would try your best to get the Archer Queen dropped as well. In terms of farming, it is going to help you out massively, guys, but also in terms of war. Now, again, if you are number one in your clan, everyone else is quite a bit lower than you, it's absolutely fine to drop this stuff, but do realize that you will be responsible for taking out the number one of the opponent clan in war, so just make sure you are ready. However, like I said, the war algorithm is very advanced nowadays, so you do not have to worry about that. So, clan castle, army camps, queen. Try and get your queen to level 5 as soon as possible. Forget about your king. Your king should be level 5 at least if you've upgraded from Town Hall 8. Probably level 10. Just leave him. Focus on the queen with your dark elixir and get that upgraded. I did drop the expos, however, what I would recommend is actually upgrading your base from the ground up. In terms of the new buildings, you should try and catch up to the old buildings. The reason for that is, let's say the expo, if I go ahead to upgrade that, I get a certain percentage increase from level 1 to 2. And that will only be, for example here, 5 days and 3 million gold. Once it is level 2 and I want to upgrade it to level 3, it will probably cost me a lot more gold and more time to upgrade. However, the percentage increase that I get is probably the same from level 1 to 2. So you can see already how the advantage is in terms of upgrading the lower buildings faster. I would definitely recommend that, guys, in terms of trying to manage your builders. Now, if you do purchase that gold pass, you will get some builder potions. If you don't and you do get into the clan war leagues, obviously they only happen once a month, you can head over into the shop. Any of these deals as well, guys, are fantastic. Again, code Judo is much appreciated. But in the league shop, you will be able to purchase hammers, everything like that. Honestly, the best use of this is the builder potion for 30 league medals. It means that when you have all 5 builders used, you can boost all 5 of them up. Now, I would never recommend using that potion when you only have one or two of them building, because you're not getting maximum benefit. It gives 10 times building speed to all active builders. So make sure you're using it when all 5 builders are upgraded. So now what do we do? Well, in terms of Town Hall 9, you get some new troops, and the Lava Hound is your new troop in the Dark Barracks. So I would be upgrading the Dark Barracks. Make sure you're getting both of them upgraded, and it will allow you to upgrade, let's show you, and get the Lava Hound. Now, you will be able to get the Witch there as well, so 2 very strong troops, but the Lava Hound is probably the best one because it is linked into the strategy I'm going to teach you at the end of this video. You might have seen I like to use Barch in order to farm. I will very quickly, before we move to the war attacks and the low level hero attacks, show you very quickly 30 seconds of how I like to Barch. Very easy. You can use a variety of strategies, but I just find this the easiest at the current level. So I would be focusing on getting the barracks upgraded, getting the spells upgraded as well, because you do unlock new spells once you get to Town Hall 9, the haste and the skeleton spell. So again, unlock the new stuff because it unlocks new strategy potentials. That is what I'm telling you guys. In terms of your research lab, make sure that is upgraded because you can then upgrade your troops to the next level. So that should be high on your priority list as well, actually. And that should be, in my opinion, before the barracks and the spell factory. Sorry for not mentioning that, but I would probably get the lab upgraded. Now, I would make sure that you get all of the troop capacity and everything done first before you start saving elixir for this. Main reason being, in farming attacks, anything like that, you're always getting that boost. It's permanently there. However, the upgrades can be a bit expensive. However, what I would be recommending is your hog riders up to level 5, because that is going to be a huge upgrade for you. Sneak peek again, guys. The hog riders is one of them strategies, but I'll show you how to use it in terms of the low level heroes. They just pack a huge amount of punch. Now I'm going to show you as well one of my war attacks from last war where I used the hog riders against a well upgraded town hall 9. I believe the queen was level 23 or so, and I used level 4 hog riders, remember, and I nearly got it done. So incredible. Get your hog riders upgraded, huge bonus. Now the witches, they are probably the best troop for town hall 9. However, they do require quite high level heroes. They do require a main force with your attack, so I actually wouldn't recommend them straight away. I would go with the hog riders, I would go with the lava hound. However, before the lava hound, go with the balloons, because the lava loon is the other strategy. So hogs and lalo are the two strategies that I would recommend as a low town hall 9, because they don't have as much emphasis on the heroes. But I will show you the strategies in a second. So they are the initial troops I would upgrade. From there, guys, it is definitely down to preference. And all of this is, in fact, whilst I can give you my intake as a long-term player of the game, I've obviously played the game for over 6 years. I do have my other accounts a lot higher than this, and I had just farmed this one to Town Hall 9, and I thought it was an ideal time to give you an upgrade guide. Obviously, this video is more educational, not as much attacking, but hopefully it points as a reference point, gives you a lot of education. And I do have the Town Hall 9 attacks playlist. I will pin it in the comments. It is in the description below, but you can go on over to that if you want to see specific Town Hall 9 strategies. So that's my recommendations in terms of troops. Ultimately, you will be upgrading all of them. The dragons is also a good solid strategy that you can use, because basically the dragons can deal with a lot of damage without the relying of the heroes. You're purely using your heroes maybe to pick off the enemy queen, maybe pick off an air defense or two. You're not doing a huge deal with them other than funneling for the dragons. The dragons are doing the main thing. So if I were to give you another troop, thinking about it, the dragons are that, and you can actually zap quake air defenses to help out with that. It is a great strategy. You'll actually find some of them in the Town Hall 9 playlists. Now, one thing I haven't mentioned as well is storages. I would actually try and upgrade your storages to that max level, because it allows you to make sure. And this is probably more if you are purchasing the gold pass, because what you get in the gold pass, you get a lot of rewards in terms of runes. Now, the runes obviously max out your gold and elixir whenever you use them. For example, the rune of elixir. And if your storages are not maxed, then it means you're not getting as much from that rune of elixir. You do get them from clan games and things like that as well, guys. So the storages I would probably have high up on that list. And not to mention, you also have the ability to upgrade your dark elixir drills. I would probably go with the dark elixir first. Main reason for that is it's a little bit more tricky to farm dark elixir when you're using easy strategies like the barch. It's very straightforward. It is very straightforward to farm gold and elixir. So I'd probably upgrade the dark elixir instead of the golden elixir. But then obviously, whenever you can increase your passive income in terms of the mines and collectors, I would always recommend that. From there, in terms of defenses, then we've described already everything that I would recommend. If you need to, I'm not going to repeat it, guys. You can literally rewind the video and watch it again. I feel I've been quite quick to go over things, but informative enough that you know exactly what you should be upgrading. In terms of defenses, my recommendation would initially be the wizard towers. They do an incredible amount of damage to hog riders and lalo, which are the two strategies that I am telling you should be focusing on on with low level heroes. So if you are that nearer person to the top of the league, you're also going to be matched with someone that's appropriately the same level as you. So if you've got maxed out wizard towers, you're going to be able to stop them. Not to mention farming, it is very good. Whenever you're setting up your base, do try and have your wizard towers near your storages so that if anyone's trying to barge it, it's a little bit annoying. That's why I have the wizard towers here with the mortar behind it. Obviously the mortar has that greater range look, so it's able to just shoot over to this area near the cannon where the barbarians and the archers, or even goblins for example, might be trying to get in. So try and protect your storages with the splash. Again, you can head over to that Clash Champs website at the end of the video if you do want to get some base designs. So the wizard towers would be my first recommendation. From there, I would probably go with the air defense. The air defense do a lot of damage again to that Lalo, which is arguably the best attack at Town Hall 9. And if you are having dragons coming at you again, then that is definitely something to do as well. In terms of upgrades though, I'm giving all of this recommendation as if you are 100% active, you are smashing the upgrades as fast as you possibly can. If that's not necessarily the case, if you're a little bit more of a passive player, you might want to, if you have enough, upgrade the most expensive thing in the base. You can click the little eye next to the builder icon right at the top, and it will more than likely suggest that most expensive upgrade. So maybe you log in, you are a bit more of a passive player. Amazingly, you collect your different amounts, and you have 6 million. You might then be upgrading one of them expos. Even if you have enough to upgrade a couple of things, the expo might be what you want to do, so long as you can keep the builders working. You want to try and have all 5 builders working if possible, but again, it is based on activity level, and it's based on your preference as well. I can give you the list that I would recommend, but ultimately what I would say is enjoy the game as well. So that is my extensive list on what to upgrade. Try and overload on the offense first, because it's going to help you in terms of attacking in war, but ultimately in your farming as well. Get your queen to level 5, mine is only level 2, but forget about your barbarian king. Just get that queen to level 5 so you get the ability, and then you can start to go from the defenses from there. I'd start with the wizard towers, and then I would branch out from there. In terms of barch then, let's very quickly show you how I like to barch. Now, I like to quickly find a base, and I relatively find them quickly where there is gold and elixir right on the outside of the base. Now, this one, look, is perfect. A great example for you. If you look at the gold mines and the elixir collectors, you can see whether they're full or not. So this one has gold next to the actual gold within the cart in the little storage, and that's how you know there's gold there. With the elixir, you can see that it's full. There are different images for if it's half full, quarter full, so you get an idea as to how full they are, but do look at how upgraded they are as well. So example, the 2 elixir collectors at the bottom are heavily upgraded in comparison to the one next to it. Well, it's not heavily, it's one level above, but there's obviously more gold and elixir, more elixir in there. Looking at the storages, we can see that there is elixir in the storages, but not in the gold. That is where the difference in terms of gold and elixir, if you look in the top left of the screen, there is nearly 100,000 more elixir. So we can assume that majority of this loot is in the mines and pumps, but there is probably 100,000 elixir as a minimum within the storages, but there's not enough to activate the next image of the gold storages. So there's very little in there. So what I'm going to do is basically just spam a line of barbarians, because my archers can hopefully, no they can't. They can't reach the elixir collectors because of the 2 layers of walls. So what we can do is use my barbarian king down here. A couple of barbs and archers to funnel. That will get everything into the base in terms of the barbarian king. He will bust through the wall, and then I can send the barbarians in as well. If you are going to get through the splash a little bit easier, I'll sometimes use a rage spell. That can be useful. I don't always use a rage spell. It just depends on whether you feel it is going to be valuable to use it. Now, basically, this is not the most ideal in terms of breaking in. Normally, you can snipe off around the side of the base, but in this instance, there is still a lot of golden elixir into that area, so it is most worthwhile busting in there. and trying to get our troops straight through. You notice that the one rage spell just helped me through, and it was definitely useful to do that. I can press the king's ability, get the elixir storage, the elixir collector, and as you can see, most of the gold is gone. There's only 18,000 that was left in the storages. At this point, you can back out if you need to. Try to save 49%. What is the odds? Try and save the health on your heroes. You don't necessarily have to worry about winning and losing. I really do not mind. You might want to. You might find a specific league that you find really nice to farm in. I particularly stay in the silver and gold league, but you can let me know in the comments if you find a better league. And that is basically what I do. I very quickly find the bases with huge amount of loot. Here's one here that I found yesterday, like this. And all you would do is surround with barbarians and archers. You don't even have to think about it. That would be my recommendation in terms of very fast, very cheap. There's not a lot of thought. However, if you do want to practice war attacks, you could cook up the war troops and attack heavier upgraded bases. You've just got to make sure that you get enough loot in return. Now let's show you two war attacks with low level heroes that you can use in order to attack as you are upgrading, so that you do have a strategy. And my recommendation would be to pick one of them so that you can just focus on the upgrades of that. Don't upgrade the loons, then the hog riders, then the lava hounds. Try and pick a strategy and then upgrade it from there, so that you've got at least one powerful strategy maximum upgraded that you can use, and then go to the other one depending on the base designs themselves. But you're far better off to have that strong attack. Let's go ahead and show you the two war attacks in order to finish off this Town Hall 9 upgrade guide. Firstly, we have the Lava Loon strategy. Now, this is a maxed out Town Hall 9. It does have mid-level heroes or slightly higher than mid-level heroes. However, what you will see at the end of the replay is that the heroes aren't even used. They are literally used to clean up some trash buildings at the end. This base was crushed without the heroes, so the level is pretty much irrelevant. Then I will show you my attack with my level 10 and my level 2 Queen. But let's get into this one. So the Lava Loon basically does not use the heroes. You can use them, and where you might use the heroes is if you can snipe off the enemy queen. However, you can use a skeleton spell in order to deal with that. You can use the skellies and also the lava pups to deal with the queen. What you're trying to do, either using your heroes initially or with a section of the Lalo, is to carve out an area of the base. So in this attack, this southern area will go down, which leaves a L shape within the base for the Lalo to sweep around the base so that you can control the balloons, because the balloons are defense targeting. So let's have a look at it. Fixie actually got a 6-pack in this war, 2 maxed out Town Hall 9s taken out. I might actually show you more of his attacks moving through the next Town Hall 9 videos. So initially, has to just send in a Lava Hound and some balloons in order to create that path we talked about. So the rage spell helps out. Let's pause for a second, because you can see how this entire bottom section is down, and that's what you want to try and do with the Lalo. Now, with the Lalo, can't even speak at the minute, guys. We can pop a Lava Hound to this air defense, and also one from a separate angle to this air defense, which means that we have a good coverage. So the balloons should be able to get in a little bit easier. They should be unscathed. So in come the balloons. We get a little bit tricky over here because there's a Tesla farm and the Lava Hound leaves the balloons behind. But not to worry, the rage spell is used for the balloons onto that area, and across they go. Now this is where it gets tricky in terms of the queen. Now look at this. The skellies are actually misplaced here. So the skeletons are in this compartment. However, the queen is in this compartment. So they're actually trying to batter through the wall to get to the queen. So the skelly spell is essentially swagged here. But what you do want to do is, over the top of that queen, use a rage spell to power your balloons forward and out of the way. But any lava pups in this area will indeed get over to the queen and take her down. Now, one thing you want to notice is, are there air defenses nearby the queen where the lava hound is likely to pop? And look at that. That was all the lava pups, which took down the queen. In come the heroes to this side, but literally they are tanking an archer tower. That is all they're doing. They're tanking one archer tower here. There's more than enough loons that would have got that down anyways. So even if the heroes were a lot lower of a level, this is a maxed out Town Hall 9 getting wiped out. Now, I'm not going to give you the impression that this is easy. A lava loon attack is incredibly difficult to get the hang of. You do want to have clean up troops. There's not a lot here, but the lava pups will work in your favor. However, you might want to use some to come around the base. However, notice this. Both hero abilities and a rage spell swagged. So that is basically no heroes, virtually. A rage swagged. A skelly swagged. Amazing. Lalo is the best attack for you at Town Hall 9. It is difficult to use, guys, but I will showcase at the end of this one. I will link you across to a Lava Loon video I have done previously so that you can get the hang of it. In fact, what I will do is I will link you across to my most recent top 3 attacks for Town Hall 9 so you get to see a bit of variety. The Hog Riders is in there. As with this Lava Loon attack, my attack was not a 3-star, but it gives you a good realization that you're not going to 3-star all of the bases, but you want a comfortable attack. Let's go ahead and show you mine using the low-level heroes to finish up. So this was my attack within this war. As you can see, it is pretty well upgraded for a Town Hall 9. We have a level 23 queen, wizard towers are maxed out, cannons maxed. I mean, I think this is virtually a maxed out Town Hall 9. Expos maxed. There is very little in this base that is not maxed out. And I'm telling you guys that I used level 4 hog riders. You've already seen that you can get level 5, so straight away, if I had my Hog Riders, which I could have actually used with a hammer of fighting, but if I had level 5 Hog Riders, this base would have gone down. However, I took a jump spell as well to try and get deeper into the base with my kill squad, and I did not need it. If I had have took an extra heal spell instead, this base would have still been 3-starred, a max Town Hall 9 from virtually a Town Hall 8. I mean, I have very few stuff to help me here at Town Hall 9. So what I thought is, yes, the Town Hall is at the side of the base. However, you will see that with competitive anti-3-star bases. The Queen for the Hog Riders is the main target, as with the Clan Castle troops. So I know I have to take down the Queen, I have to take down the Clan Castle troops to stand any chance with my Hog Riders. The King's at the other side of the base. And whilst I have a very low Town Hall 9 in terms of my upgrades, I cannot bring anything in to get this King. I just have to try and hope the Hog Riders get past him. But I do need to get this area. So what I thought is, why don't I wall break one of these compartments and send a kill squad into this area. I'll take 2 golems because I don't have heavily upgraded heroes, so I do need to take golems to help. That's something you're going to have to do if you have low level heroes. Take troops in order to tank, whether that be giants or golems. I like the golems since they're not susceptible to spring traps to come into this area. I note that the town hall is out of region, so I do put a wizard there. However, it's going to go down with the kill squad. You've got to note that there's high HP storages, so essentially it's going to take my troops a little while to get through there, and I've got to sneak them wall breakers in. Then what I thought is, maybe I can jump here and get lucky to take a lot of this down. Now, that was definitely overestimating things based on the fact that I only have some wizards behind them golems and my king and queen. I decided to take extra hog riders within the clan castle, but if you do have access to bowlers, that would have been a primary thing to get in here. Max level bowlers would have assured me that I virtually took out all of this. So let's go ahead and show you the replay, and then you will get to see just how powerful this is. Now again, guys, I did not get the 3-star, and that's something I want you to realize. By the way, I used some minions over here to speed up time because I knew from a previous attack that there were no Tesla over there. So I want you to realize that if you have low level heroes, you cannot be expecting to get 3-stars against maxed level bases all of the time. In fact, you will very rarely get it. So go for the high percentage 2-star, do go for the 3-star, but just know it's very unlikely. So, everything comes in. We've got the town hall, we've got the funnel, king and queen coming into this area, they will get access to that queen, and I use a rage spell to help. Then I have my poison for the clan castle troops coming out, and remember, they are the two main targets here, so you've got to get them as a minimum, which is what I did. Now, I noticed that I wasn't going to get both of these wizard towers, so I started heavy with the hogs, and I need good coverage of the hogs to try and get them into the center. Otherwise, there's a good chance they just go up and around. I need to try and get them into this area, so that's why I have a good spread of the hogs from either side. This is my second heal. Now imagine I used the skelly just in case I needed it for the queen or anything. Imagine if I didn't use that jump, which was basically swagged, and I had a heal spell right there. The hog riders get through them two wizard towers, they get through the expo, the heal would only just be wearing off now, and my hog riders are gone, but they would have still been there, and I think with the extra heal, I would have got this base. So if I had just took the heal, I would have got the base. If I had have had my hog riders upgraded, I would have got the base. However, it's still a good percentage 2-star attack. It ends up being just shy of 80%, despite being a Town Hall 8 virtually. Yes, I have the upgraded army camps, and yes, I have a level 2 queen, but that is it. Versus a maxed out Town Hall 9, virtually. That is a good attack, that is a good strategy which is comfortable for you, but if you do want to see my top 3 Town Hall 9 strategies, this is probably when you're a little bit more upgraded, you can click this video in order to check that one out. If you are going up against lower Town Hall 9s, then these strategies still work. Be sure to leave me a like on the video if you've liked it, guys, if you've enjoyed it, but check out the top 3 Town Hall 9 strategies, that will help you out as well. We'll be back here again tomorrow for more Clash of Clans, so until then, take care.